that if I don't do three steps and jump through the hoop, I can't have it. But then that's a lie right there, because when Jesus read the book, the Bible said he sat down. He didn't sit in the seat of Moses. He didn't sit in Abraham. He sat in the seat of the Messiah. And he told him, amen, he took his place of authority. Amen. He sat down when he was appointed to sit down. Jump to 428 and 30 right quick so they know I ain't playing.
And all they in the synagogue, when they heard these things, were filled with wrath.
People get mad when you sit down when you're supposed to sit down.
Right.
As long as you running around and you running and you don't know who you are, people don't worry about it. As long as you don't have no confidence in God, people don't worry about you. But when you take that place of authority, people going to look at you. They're going to be ready to take you out. They're going to be ready to take you down. But what you got to know, you got to sit in your seat of authority. Because God has put a place and he has a designated place for us to rest in him. That he is a resting place. Amen. Is that a resting place? So we got to sit down in our seat of authority. As long as you run around following people, they don't have no problem with that. Amen. But when you sit down in your place of authority and say, well, God is touching me and telling me to do something else. Oh, they don't want you to sit down. Amen. But as long as you laughing and joking with us, but when you take your time to go pray, they don't want you to go pray. They're going to pick at you because you're sitting down when you're supposed to sit down there. My God, they tell you when you already ain't got no money, so what you going to try to sow for anyway? Amen. They talk about it because they don't want you to be blessed. So they know if you give, what God gonna give back to you. So, but when you sit down, they get upset with you. They want you to stay in some old religious rhetoric, some old battling stuff, some stuff.